Hello, hello. I'm Juliana Hever, the plant-based dietitian, and this is the What Would Juliana Do Q&A. I have a lot of questions about eating healthy on a budget because one of the number one obstacles to success for a lot of people is thinking that eating a whole food plant-based diet can be expensive. And I want to debunk that because, in fact, you could save a lot of money, and there's even research showing that it is ideal to eat a plant-based diet because you're sticking to more of these staple, whole staple foods, and they happen to be more affordable. So I wanted to give you 7 tips today for eating healthy on a budget. First of all, buy foods that have a longer shelf life. You know, have dried grains and dried legumes. They last a long time so that there's less potential for waste. So do canned goods, absolutely. You know, there's canned beans and canned tomato products and jarred tomato products. There's aseptic packaging, all those things that last a long time on the shelf that will help you maximize the time span that you have to utilize those foods with minimal waste. So that's one tip. Secondly, shop local farmers markets. I don't know how it's going right now, but there have been opportunities where this whole marketplace has expanded, where there are farmers markets everywhere, more and more places around the world, and definitely around the US. I know that's become more and more popular, which is wonderful. So sometimes you can go there and you can get some better deals. You could buy in bulk, or you can get to know the local farmers. And sometimes if you go at the end of the market when they're closing down, you can get even better deals because they're trying to get rid of all of their whatever they have there, their produce that they had. That's a great way to try to maximize price on fruits and vegetables, because those can tend to be sometimes more expensive than not, but it depends on the season and it depends on where you are buying them. The third thing is to, you know, one way we could save money is to not always use these packaged and convenience foods. Convenience foods are fabulous. I love getting pre-cut salads and vegetables just because it saves so much time, but you can save money usually by buying the actual vegetable and by buying more in bulk instead of the actual convenience food. And of course, when you're buying stuff that's already prepared, like already cooked for you, that's more expensive. It's less expensive to cook it yourself at home, which leads me to the next one, is to cook more often. This sounds oversimplified, but it is so extraordinarily helpful, which I think a lot of people have recognized with the current situation in the world, where a lot of us have been forced to stay home, obviously. And because of that, we've needed to cook more. Restaurants have been closed. What a wonderful opportunity to learn how to cook if you didn't know previously. And you know, you can make all sorts of things. There's nothing healthier than eating soups and salads and sides and sweets all made from whole plant foods. And learning how to cook and prepare them and put them together in different combinations that you love is a wonderful lifelong habit that is widely, widely beneficial. I would say that the best way to learn how to cook, if you haven't, because I had to teach myself how to cook as well, is recipes. I always say recipes are a template. They don't have to be perfect, but there's a great place to start. So if you want to, like, if you know what you like to eat, and now with the internet being so, you know, accessible, there's so many wonderful recipes and cookbook authors and recipe developers out there that there's no lack of options, and you can just start digging, just start finding things that you love. Of course, you can look at our health span solution, because my favorite recipes are in that book as well, and all of the last books that I've worked on and written. But there's so many out there. I have hundreds of them on my website at plantbaseddietitian.com. You will find stuff that sounds delicious. Start with one, make it if you love it. I put a heart on mine and I save it in a pile, or on my book, I save them. I bookmark them like crazy, dog ear them and highlight them and write notes. If you don't like it, you could always modify it. You can basically say, oh, I took out this or added more chipotle powder, which is something I would do, or hot sauce because I like everything hot and spicy. Whatever it is, you can make your little notes on there and then you can modify it next time. If you don't like it, don't ever make it again. You know, you could try to save it as best you can, but you know, sometimes it's just not a good recipe. And that way you'll learn how to do certain things. You'll learn different techniques. You'll learn how to use different ingredients. You'll learn how to use and integrate spices and herbs, which is really important because people get overwhelmed by it, myself included, but you'll learn how to pair and how to combine spices and herbs by following the recipes because someone already created these before. And you will also learn your trusted cookbook authors or recipe creators, because you will know that even if it sounds weird or sounds complicated, when you do it and you get to the end result and you love it, you know that you can trust their methodology and their flavor profile. So look for your favorite cookbook or recipe creators out there, and then build upon that. And this will help you tremendously. The next thing, the fifth tip, is to prepare. It's really helpful to prepare lists. You know, before you go shopping, write lists of everything that you need. Like, look at the recipes ahead of time, know what you're gonna buy. This, most importantly, will reduce waste. You know, this is my weakness too. I'm working on getting better at not wasting food. I used to travel a ton, and it was like always a whole puzzle to try to figure out how much do I need for how long I'm here, I'm home, and what will I, so I don't have to waste anything. And I was always giving away food because I'd end up with too much. Often that happened, but I'm getting better. So I'm a work in progress too, as everyone else is. My sixth tip is never shop hungry. Have you noticed that if you go to the store and you are hungry, your cart has so many things on there that wasn't on your list that you never intended to buy? It's really easy to impulse shop when you're hungry because, like I always say, everything sounds good when you're hungry. You know, everything sounds more and more delicious the hungrier you are. So that's why it's important to eat before you shop. And the seventh and final tip for today is try growing your own food. This is a wonderful thing too that has evolved during this whole at-home quarantine environment, is that so many people are learning how to garden, and they're using hydroponics and other technologies to be able to create their own food. Even if you're making your own fresh herbs, you can save money by doing that at home with a little garden. So again, something I'm working on. It's a work in progress for me as well, but it is something I strive to be able to master, at least to some extent. And it is a wonderful way to grow your own food and have access to stuff you love to eat and is, of course, nutritious and delicious. So please let me know your tips and your questions and your comments below in the comment section or via direct message, or you can reach out to me on my website, plantbaseddietitian.com. Thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you next time.